Hi there. This is my kit for DXing with my Bonito MegActive MA305 antenna, which consists of obviously that antenna and the Sony ICF2001D portable, one of the best ever. Many of you will have seen some of the videos on the channel recently using this antenna from my trip to Crete. Quite a few personal firsts were had DXing with this antenna. The environment there electrically, it was much quieter than at home, not as quiet as the woods obviously, but despite that, the antenna performed really well and copied some really nice stuff. As I said, some of you will have seen it. Since I got back from Crete, I have taken this kit out on a sort of late night, early hours of the morning DX'pedition to the woods in a very quiet environment, and it performed really well. I copied a lot of what I consider to be really hardcore DX, and I need to check, but I think I actually obtained another personal first from one of the low power South Americans. I'll have to double check it, because there's about 1,500 videos on my channel, and I'm not even sure if I've heard it before or not, but it performs superbly. One of the questions I've been asked quite commonly is, how does all this lot plug together? So the quickest way to use this antenna is to carry it with you all plugged together, so that all you have to do is hit the power switch, connect the radio. But for the purposes of clarity, I'm going to show you how it all bolts together on this video. You'll get an idea anyway. So, starting with the coaxial power inserter, maybe you can see it's quite sunny here. So, BNC, bayonet, antenna, receiver, 5 volt USB power from that via that socket, 12 volt via that socket. Bonito supply this antenna with the USB cable, like so, and they supply the power block, like so. Also got two sockets, 5 volts in and 5 volts out. 5 volts out for powering the antenna, 5 volts in for charging. And when I use this, I use it for sometimes several hours, and then just plug it into the mains and come back to it the next day or whatever. It's never actually run out of charge when I've actually been DXing, so I don't know how long it will last. Maybe it could go for weeks, who knows. But it's good for several hours for sure. So that's the power. Bonito supplied me, but it doesn't come with the antenna, a 1 meter length of H155 coax for the receiver side. There we go. And they also supplied me a 10 meter length of H155 for the antenna side, like so. So there you go. So, amplifier. Radiating element just simply screws in. You can use whatever element you want, you can use various elements, attach pieces of wire to this thing, to the amplifier, and then BNC to the antenna side. Like so. There we go. With the antenna. Should we go into it? And then it's just a case switching on the receiver. And so on the receiver side, I use this patch cable that I made, which basically takes you from BNC bayonet to 3.5 millimeter jack plug straight in there, and then straight into the receiver, And then all you then have to do is turn on the power and you're ready to go. And it's simple as that. Just see if I can find something to listen to. So power on, power off, simple as that. So that's basically it. So in less than 6 minutes, I've explained a bit of the background, plugged it all together, and you're listening to the radio. As I said, I have this all plugged together in the flight case, and all you literally have to do is hit the power button on the USB block, power block, and plug it into the radio, and away you go. So it's literally possible to have this thing up and running in less than a minute, really. The length of time it takes basically to uncoil the coaxial cable and mount the antenna. I showed you on a previous video, I've got a little setup with my cheap camera tripod, which puts this thing 4 meters into the air. And I used that on the late night, early hours of the morning DX'pedition a couple of days ago. So, and I don't know how much of a difference it makes, but I read quite often that e-field antennas perform a little bit better, a bit further away from the ground. So it's easy to do, cheap, didn't cost me anything actually. And so that's how I used it. But here you have a completely portable DXing kit that you can throw in the back of the car. If you use a smaller radio, something like the Eaton satellite, or even smaller, you can use them for smaller flight case. But either way, you know, you have this totally portable solution to DXing on the move. Brilliant. And in terms of overall sort of sensitivity, I think I was surprised at how well this antenna performed out in the woods. When you compare the signals, some of the signals that I recorded, and the quality of them in terms of sort of clarity, strength, etc., to even, you know, 100 meter long wires that I've used in the past, it surprised me. And I think some of you will be actually quite pleasantly surprised at how well such a short antenna, physically short antenna, performs so well on the tropical band mainly. But I'd copy some signals a bit further up the shortwave band, but copied a lot of really good stuff on the tropical bands. So as I said, those videos to come when I've finished uploading my stuff from Crete. There's probably another 4 or 5 from Crete, and a couple of other bits and pieces that I want to upload. But as I said, I've been asked quite a lot recently, how this antenna, how does it all kind of, like, what is it, how does it all plug together? So so there you go. It's an amplifier, power inserter, USB cable, USB power block, and 2 lengths of coaxial cable, and that's kind of it really. So I hope that was of some interest, and I'll look forward to uploading the videos of this setup in action in a very, very quiet environment. I'll be really interested in feedback from you guys on that, because surprised me at how well this sort of ultra compact piece of kit performed. Okay, well, thanks for watching.